here's a question that I have seen posed often in the last 3 years that I've been involved with Release Time Bible Education that I would love to address, and that is, why can't students just be taught the Bible in their own homes by their own parents and in their own churches? And of course, the answer is they can, and they should. However, all the effort, all the money we've raised, all of the planning and all of the execution that we've done is for this reason. We want every high school student, regardless of their parents' ability or availability, to be able to participate in academically rigorous Bible education, 90 minutes a day. And in our case right now, a seminary-trained teacher, a certified teacher, the opportunity to gain high school credit for this class. We want them to leave with sound biblical instruction. We want them to know what they believe, why they believe it, and be able to defend their faith as they go forward in life.
We use a curriculum called Firm Foundations. The part one is creation through Christ. It takes us through talking about God in the beginning, and then it takes us through the creation and through the line of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, through all through the Israel's history, all the way up into the life of Christ, through the life of Christ, his crucifixion and his ascension into heaven. And then the second part of the curriculum is the New Testament. It begins with the birth of the church and takes us through the epistles, and so it's an opportunity to learn more about the New Testament as well.
I believe we have some really great families in our community who strive to teach their children about the Lord and really raise them up, teaching them the Bible and bringing them to church each week. And I think the Christian Learning Center just comes alongside families and helps us to just reinforce those things that we've spent so much time teaching, and just helps to kind of bring together and put into context all those Bible stories that they learn in Sunday school, and that time that you spend just teaching them good values at home. And so I've just really been impressed with the way that the Christian Learning Center is just bringing some great teaching to our students at the high school.
In an area where we may be so saturated with the church, we're in the middle of the Bible Belt, it can be easy to think that that is common knowledge amongst our families and our community members and our students. But I think it can be easy to let that so-called common knowledge be enough. And I see students come from church families, unchurched families, and yet so many of them still haven't read the Word of God for themselves. They kind of lack that that biblical literacy, you might say, that they know things in their heads, but it hasn't become personal to them. It hasn't been an experience that they've had. It's based on someone else's experience or hearsay. And so I think that can be dangerous when, if our faith as a community, if it's just based on hearsay. So I think one of the most impactful things that the Christian Learning Center has to offer is that students come in on a daily basis and they're confronted with the Word for themselves, and they look it in the eye and have to work through that in their hearts. And I think it's important that we at least give them that foundation.
I believe this program can benefit the community by showing people who God is and who Christ is. And when you have Christ in anything, it's going to be better.
If other students were wanting to take this and weren't sure, I really think they should, because I know a lot of people are worried about what others are going to think if they take it or what they'll say about them, but that shouldn't matter. And this class really does help a lot with understanding the Bible and just answering a lot of questions that they may have.
Someone really close to me actually had asked me a question, and they were like, I believe in God and I know that He's there, but sometimes I have my doubts. And then they were like, I don't know, because there's nothing physical that I've ever known. And because of the class that I took and because of Lynn Ray teaching us what he taught us, I was able to say, well, actually, there's a lot of factual stuff in the Bible. And I was able to talk to them about, if you go over to the Holy Land, you can visit the tombs of different biblical figures. Like, you can go to Pontius Pilate's tomb, And when I started telling this person that, they were like, I had no idea. That's really cool.
I think a lot of times students have heard things that they said, somebody will say the Bible says, and for the student to be able to go to the Bible and actually read what somebody has said that the Bible says and understand it for themselves, that they're able to give a better defense of what the Bible teaches about God, about man, about life in general. And so I think it's very helpful, and it assists these students to have a better understanding of Scripture.
It taught me better how to defend my faith. And because we would be up there and Liam would ask us hard questions, and the questions that, you know, if you didn't really think about, if someone hit you with that question and you were in conversation, you'd be like, I have no idea. But through that class, it taught me more about how to stand up for my faith. And when someone questions and asks the hard questions, it taught me how to better answer those and like how to be more confident in what I'm saying.
There are always challenges in any program. Right now, we definitely need funding. We have hired a program director / teacher, Stephanie Lloyd, and we're so excited. And of course, the Christian Learning Center hired me this year. So we're gonna need funding for 2 new positions. And the reason that it's important for the Christian Learning Center to have these hired positions is now we have 2 people that are working every single day for these students, and that is their primary focus. Before, the board was doing the work of the executive director, and they were doing a fabulous job, but they all had full-time jobs. They had, you know, parents, they had children, they had wives and husbands. They had other responsibilities that sometimes had to take priority, and now this gets to be my priority, and I love it. And Stephanie is wonderful. She is our program director, teacher. She works with Billy Smith. She's so creative, really works so hard behind the scenes. So we're just so thankful to have her. There's always challenges buying new curriculum, Bibles.
I hope people continue to give to this program because, like I had said earlier, a lot of this didn't really click until the class. And I'd heard these stories but didn't understand them, and now they just have a place in my heart.
One of the big reasons that someone would donate to this class is materials, and specifically like Bibles, because I know there are so many kids in this county who have never read the Bible because they can't get one or they don't have one. And a lot of people up there that took that class, it was surprising how many people didn't have a Bible. Like, they're not cheap necessarily, so for the teacher to have, like, for the teacher to go out there and give their own money to buy a Bible for, there were close to 30 kids in my class, 25, 30 kids. So if half the class didn't have a Bible, you know, it's hard on a teacher to go and pay money out of pocket for that Bible. So if you like, for people to donate to the program, we'd be able to give a Bible to anybody.
So right now we only have a third period class, and that interferes with some of the other classes, maybe your primary classes. But with the funding that we get through the gala this year, we can help to pay for more classes and other things that are needed for the Campbell County Christian Learning Center.
The Christian Learning Center has had a profound impact on my family, specifically because my son Charlie has been part of the class now. This is his second semester, and it's just been such a good opportunity for him to really learn more about God's Word and just to study and learn to make it his own. And so I would encourage anyone to give to the Christian Learning Center, because this is a great ministry to invest in, because when you invest in the Christian Learning Center, you're investing in students learning God's Word, which can really make a huge difference in their life and the lives of their family, and also just give them the opportunity to influence the community around them.
Anytime you get the kids to interact with Scripture, to read it, not just to hear it, something if they go to church, and some do and some don't, this is the only story of Jesus and God as it's threaded throughout the Old and New Testament, that they might ever have the experience to really get a good immersion into that theology and the Bible and what it teaches about God and what it teaches about ourselves and how necessary it is for us to love God and to love people and the reason why we do that. And so I think a lot of times for students, it's an opportunity, first of all, to just have those moments with God.
Jesus, the Word of God, Christianity is so far out of the school system. I think that it is very, very important that we keep it as much as we can. And by having this program, and all the funding, you know, I think that it's really helping people to understand.
When Jesus told us to go and make disciples of all nations, he also said to baptize them and to teach them to obey his commands. And so I think it can be easy to stop there, where we think discipleship is this moment of salvation, and that is the beginning, but discipleship is a daily process. And so what a privilege it is to walk beside these students who not only, you know, function individually, but they impact their families, and they are the future of our community and our world, that we don't want to just say, you know, we've gotten a bunch of people saved, but can we say that we've really made disciples by teaching people to obey the Lord's word and the Lord's commands?
We had one student who gave their life to Christ last semester, which is always the most important thing. We have foreign exchange students who come who have never heard the name Jesus, and they leave knowing that there is a God that loved them enough to send his own son to this world to die on the cross and to be risen again for their sins. And that is an amazing opportunity that we would never have without this program.
Thank you.
Thank you.